Hello, I'm Mr. Arnager, a retired lecturer in metallurgy, preaching Christianity and Sikhism. Here I'm going to tell you why Easter is celebrated with eggs. And here's a demonstration by Mary Magdalene in the court of the emperor. In the court of the Roman Emperor, Emperor Tiberius. And so first he laughed, you know, then when it was turning, becoming alive and turning red and then bright white, then he listened to the gospel carefully. However, he was one who was interested in gospel, twice born, but he was of a discerning intellect. People who are discerning intellect, you will find them to be jovial and cheerful, you know, not like the first born people. They are very straight, they keep their mouths, you know, very, that this is the law, this is what it says, and this is done, you know. They go by the law, no spirit. Whereas the twice-born people, they go by the spirit and keeping in mind the law. They don't override it, but at the same time, they give a proper justification to spirit and not just accuse him and hang him. So here is what I found on Wikipedia. Easter egg tradition. For centuries, it has been the custom of many Christians of the book created by the Messianic Jews. You know, the Messianic Jews, when they enter the Church of God, they bring in their written Torah, which was the deadly poison for the spirit of the New Testament. So when they bring in deadly poison written Torah, then the desire to learn or know the gospel in spirit was killed. And when the blindness came in the church, then they did whatever they liked. They formed the Nicene Creed, this and that. They're all nonsense creed, if you see carefully. But most of the people, even today in churches, they just go in the churches, mostly for social reason. And there are many who go to worship our Father God, to glory, in honor of Jesus. But they are misled, you know. So Jesus is not known by going into the church and praying and all that, which is Antichrist. But if you are of discerning intellect, then only you can have part with him. Remember Jesus when he feed the 5,000? And then Jesus opened his mouth. You can't preach gospel to a hungry man. He said, unless you eat the flesh of Jesus and drink the blood of Christ, you have no part in me. So those people who were men of letters, when they said, Jesus said, eat the flesh, like Nicodemus, they said, hey, shall we chop him in small pieces and eat him? No, not me. They all run away. Even his own laborers, only the own 12 laborers, they too were astonished. What the hell he is talking about? But when Jesus explained to them that in the beginning was the word can't speak. It need flesh to speak. and that flesh was of Jesus. So what came out of the mouth of Jesus, you should understand with this ear. This is called eating the blood, eating the flesh of Jesus. After you have digested in your heart what the saying are understood the underlying meaning of the parables, then you preach gospel from your own mouth. Not that this book say, that book say, that book say, no, from your own mouth with confidence as expected of a Christ. Then you are drinking the blood of Christ. Then you are part and parcel of Christ Jesus, as proved at the Last Supper. The 12 were so well trained that if a stranger come to find out who is the real Christ among them, they would not have been able to. So that's why they hired Judas Iscariot, a twice born of evil spirit, to pinpoint who is the real Christ. So in Jesus, we are to be solitary, not form a group like these people are having today, synagogues of Satan. So be careful. And this egg I'm going to describe now. So these, for centuries it has been the custom of many Christians of the book created by the Messianic Jews to share dyed and painted eggs, particularly on Easter Sunday. The eggs represent new life of the bird of the air, the twice born by the grace of our Father God and Jesus, and Jesus not and not Christ, which is spirit, bursting forth from the tomb. So it was Jesus who burst forth from the tomb, not the Christ, you know, physical body. Among Eastern Orthodox Christians, the dead in spirit Christians of the book, that they addressed our Father God as Lord, that have slave disciples, as the Rabbi used to have, Pharisee Sadducee, as by the Rabbis of the Yahweh used to have, but no more. So this sharing is accompanied by the proclamation of age of Christ. Not Christ is reborn or risen. Christ never died. And how can he rise then if he never died? It was Jesus who died on the cross. Jesus, this physical self. So by resurrection, he has pointed out, you know, that it is the time of the Christ. So, age of Christ, because Christ is the light, and that light dispels this darkness which we have now. The killing and all that could be explained in Jesus when we explain the gospel with Christ in our heart. Christians can't explain gospel, they can't touch it. So age of Christ has started with the resurrection of Jesus and his friends. Remember, Lazarus was resurrected to show to everyone, but when Jesus himself was resurrected, only those who believed in Jesus, they could see him. Remember that the real imperishable self, Christ, cannot be seen by the residents of relatively tribal world of Adam. So tribal world of Adam, they see the logical eye of third eye for logical reasoning. It perceive only through that eye, third eye of logical reasoning, you can perceive Christ Jesus. You can't see him. Remember that anybody who talks about sin and prophets today is Antichrist. This is by John in Luke 16, verse 16. Law and prophets were tell John the Baptist. Law, but that leads to sin. So no more sin. And law and prophets. Prophets were sent to the people when the rabbis were good. Mend your way. Do this way, that way. Then the last prophet was John the Baptist, who came to tell them, mend your way. And that's why when he was baptizing in Jordan, he was baptizing Jewish men in the name of Abraham, and he baptized Jesus in the name of his father, Heavenly Father, Yahweh. So he was the firstborn of Yahweh, or the second Adam. So after John the Baptist, if anybody who mentioned sin in churches or anywhere, he is Antichrist. And if he is Antichrist, you will suffer, you know, at his hands. Because after that, blasphemy has taken over sin, which is more serious. Because blasphemy originates from your own heart. And then it is very serious, not forgivable. It's no more coming from the book or the written books which the rabbi can forgive. No way. Remember that the real imperishable self, Christ, cannot be seen by the residents of relatively tribal world of Adam. Here it may be worth bringing to you this chart so that you know where we stand. Yes. So this is the different ages, you know, also. Now, there are four ages, and the first one is this one, in which people are one with God and join the company of God. Perfect, you know, nothing lacking. Then, as the people become degenerated in qualities of religion or dharma, they are represented by four legs. They are one, two, three, and four legs. This is the tribal people. That unless you have tribal shame, or you are the salt of the earth, you cannot be religious. So the intake of the temple priest or of the rabbi used to be the tribal people. And anybody who did not mention his tribe, he wasn't taken in. Or there were certain conditions which they take them in. Like the bastard born of the temple dancing girls. They are taken in by the teachers to teach them the moral laws. He gave them all the religious education. And then when they come from this is like vegetation. Because these people are helic, are the once born. They do what their rabbi tells them to do. They are disciples of the rabbi, dead in spirit. So those who become of discerning intellect, they start thinking, you know, why, what this rabbi is doing, this, that. And they got twice born. When they are twice born, they represent egg. This is vegetation, like tree, plants and other things. And this is represented by egg, discerning intellect, that they can think about it twice born. Then there are three here, which is also spirit, sealed to serve God. They are born anything of placenta. So they represent this class. So of the placenta, human birth is the top. Human beings are the king of the creation. So up to this one, you can see helic, psychic, pneumatic. They can see, but fourth one is purely spiritual. They are saint and other who appear and disappear at their own will. And they come as floating, as Jesus came floating into this world. So they are representing things, you know, which are appear and disappear to help the devotee of our Father God. So this is more advanced, but however, keep it up to this egg. Egg is the situation where people are twice born of discerning intellect. One tradition concerning Mary Magdalene says that following the death and resurrection of Jesus, she used her position to gain an invitation to a banquet given by the Roman Emperor Tiberius. Now this is wrong, you know. We don't ask for it, that we want to sit there like these temple priests. The rabbis were demanding. So they were having their position, you know, by invitation or by, it was fulfilled, you know, in their law. As you have in the Church of England, the bishop go and sit in the House of Lords. But automatically, but not in the same was going on during the Roman, but not the brethren of Jesus ever were invited by the Roman Emperor come and take a seat. So this is Messianic Jews who wanted to be in the all the temple or functions, you know. One tradition concerning the Mary Magdalene says that following the death and resurrection of Jesus, she used her position. That is wrong, you know, it is insulting. To gain an invitation, again, as if she is begging someone, that is wrong. To a banquet given by the Roman Emperor Tiberius. So we were not hungry of food which emperor was giving, because other people could be, but not in Jesus. When she met him, she held a plain egg in her hand and exclaimed, the era of Christ has begun. The era was of the rabbi, which kept the thing, rulers, they kept the people under thumb. So Jesus, by giving his sacrifice, set us free of those temple rabbis, rulers. And that is You need to have Christ in your heart to know gospel. If you have no Christ in your heart, you are not solitary and you have no gospel. Jesus was solitary. His laborers were solitary because they can't enter into the vineyard of our Father. That is a narrow gate only for the solitary. So the emperor laughed and said that Jesus and not Christ rising from the dead was as likely as the egg in her hand turning red while she held it. Now this is a story, again a little bit temper given, but however, he was of discerning intellect, and out of his intellect, though he challenged, I can't see Jesus returning or resurrection of Jesus. So if, like egg, if you can make him alive, then I can believe it, Before he finished speaking, the egg in her hand turned a bright red, and she continued proclaiming the gospel to the entire imperial house. Egg represents twice-born people of spirit who remained silent, as the rabbis were psychic crooks, the same as here doctor, priests, pope, etc. are today, hushing down the voices of those who want to preach gospel. Thus, they were looking for a shepherd, which our Father God sent, and he gave them the necessary courage to learn and preach gospel, making their desires to preach gospel living. So today, we have no excuse to keep our mouths shut against these antichrist, hireling dog-collar priests, bishops, popes, etc., the old hierarchy of the synagogue of Satan, prophesied by Jesus in Matthew 12, verse 43 to 45, making the situation worse than before the arrival of Jesus. So they fulfill this prophecy, and they are sons of the Most High Satan. But they put on these dog-collar priests and other things, and they are hypocrites, because they are not working for God, but for money. At the end of the month, they want money. Those people who work for God, they give to the church, take nothing out of the church. So be of discerning intellect in raising your voices against the antichrists. So you have to be very alert. There's another version of this story can be found in popular belief, mostly in Greece. It is believed that after the crucifixion, Mary Magdalene and the Virgin Mary put a basket full of eggs at the foot of the cross. There, the eggs were painted red by the blood of the Christ. Then Mary Magdalene brought them to Tiberius Caesar. So this is a unit to make up, to make people believe. Once-born people, they are the disciples. They can't believe the things which are of twice-born supernatural Father. So they produce this version, to mislead the people and to confuse them. So the real story is that this dark age is the age of intelligent people, discerning intellect, people of discerning intellect. What type of people they should be? Like the birds of the air. Remember that parable where Jesus said, the parable of the sower, some seed fell on flat ground. Flat ground means firstborn people, when they speak from their mouth than the bird of the air, people. Twice more, they hear the word and they make, hey, where from this come from? It makes sense to me. So then they make sense, you know, and they went to get the more of it and preached gospel. And hope this will make sense. And I have put another video on a similar topic, you know, why Easter is celebrated, the Easter egg. And hope these two will complement each other. Our Father God, bless you.